Okay, today I'm going to show you how to create a prank application similar to a popular video. Click the link to see it. What this prank app will do is to make the user think he's opening up Mozilla Firefox, but instead he gets the following. Before we begin, we're going to need the following. First, we're going to need a scary picture, and make sure you get a large one because the smaller ones get fuzzy when you stretch them out. We're also going to need a scary sound. Remember, the louder and the more obnoxious, the better. We're also going to need a Firefox icon, and it has to be an ICO file. We can easily download the Firefox picture from Google as a JPEG or as a PNG file. Then we can go to one of these icon convert websites. I use iconconverticons.com. Okay, so let's get started. Make a new project in Visual Basic. Make sure Windows Form application is selected, and let's call it Mozilla Firefox. All right, now let's add the picture, the sound, and the icon to the project. So to do that, go to Project, then Mozilla Firefox Properties. There, the first thing we're going to do is to change the icon to the Firefox icon. So click Browse and select the icon. I saved mine on the desktop. So notice how the icon now changes to Firefox. To add the picture, just go to the Resources tab, Add Resource, Add Existing File, and I saved my picture on the desktop. To add an audio file, it's similar to adding a picture. Go to Add Resources, Add Existing File, and ensure that the file type setting is set for WAV. Okay, so there's my audio. Click Open, and now we can start on the form. Okay, so click on form1.vb to go to form view. Then let's change the size of the form to 1313 by 654. Also, don't forget to change the window state for the form to be maximized. That will make the form stretch out across the screen during runtime. After the form, we're going to add a picture box, and the size of the picture box should also be 1313 by 654. Now let's add the picture to the picture box. So click on image. The picture has already been imported and it's underneath the word none. So just click on it and don't worry if you can't fully see the image right now. Just hit OK. There's the picture, but it looks kind of funny. So we gotta stretch it out. To do that, we have to click on this play button looking thing, then switch it to stretch mode and notice the difference now. Okay, so now we just have to add the sound to the form. And to do that, we need to add some code. So double click on the form. And we're gonna add under the declaration section, right above subform one load, you're gonna add the following. Friend with events player as new system.media.sound player. Under the subform one load, you're gonna add player.stream is equal to my.resources, and in my case, dot guy screams like a girl. And underneath, put down player. Dot play, open and close parentheses. And then if you want, click run if you want to see what the program will look like. But at this point, we're ready to publish it. Okay, first thing we have to do is to do a save all. Then we got to take note of the folder where the application files are stored. That's very important because this is where we will find our executable file. Okay, so just click save. Now to publish it, go back to the application properties, then click on the publish wizard. Change the publish folder to your desktop for now, then click open. We don't need to change anything on the next three windows. So just keep hitting next and then click finish. When the program is published, you will see the folder where you created the files. Now, when you install the application, you will get these two icons. For this project, we don't need those, so you can just delete them. What we do need, however, is the executable file, and we can find that in the VB project folder. If you forgot where that was, go to the debug tab. Then click on Options and Settings, click Projects and Solutions, and there it tells you where it is. Okay, so when you publish a program, Visual Basic creates an executable file, which can be found by clicking the Project folder, then double-click Mozilla Firefox, then Bin, then Debug, and there it is. So just drag the executable to the desktop. All right, so check out the difference between the real icon and the fake icon. It's looking pretty good. Now take the real icon and send it to the trash. Don't worry, after we scare a few people, we'll restore it. This program will work best on those who don't know anything about computers.
If you like this video, make sure you click on that like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.